Would you be able to see the slides?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, ma'am.
Okay, let us continue with the clinical procedures, what we done for the eyeball. First one is applanation tonometry. So this was the test which was done for glaucoma. Usually glaucoma is the condition because of increased intracranial pressure. So what they will do is, they will test the amount of pressure to flatten your cornea. They will press the finger. Usually they will put the eye drops and they will numb the eye. So whenever you go to the ophthalmology clinic, so they'll ask you first to take the eye drops. One is to prevent the infections. If the doctor or the physician, if he want to touch your eyeball, to prevent that infection, priorly they'll give you some eye drops. So, and also it will numb the eye also. It won't cause any discomfort for us. So that's why if we put the eye drops, that will numb the eye. Then they will press the eyeball and they will see the pressure at which, if they can feel the pressure is more increasing, then they can suspect the person is having glaucoma. So that type of test we call it as applanation tonometry. And next, blepharoplasty. Blepharo means eyelids. Plasty means surgical repair. Surgical or plastic surgery done particularly to the eyelids. We call it as blepharoplasty, which is usually cosmetic in nature. So with blepharoplasty, they can increase the eyelid also. And next, capsulotomy. So removing a part of lens capsule, we call it as capsulotomy. Contact lens. So we all know to correct the hyperopia and myopia, which is farsightedness and nearsightedness. So we usually go for glasses, and putting glasses, we call it as cylindrical correction. And the next option is contact lens. And corneal transplant. So replacing the damaged cornea with the donor corneal tissue. So this is usually when the patient was dead or any person was died, then they will collect the cornea within 20 minutes of death. So then the cornea will be, the doctor can use the cornea or else they can't use. So that's why when the person was dead, immediately we have to intimate to the hospital. And cup to disc ratio, which has to evaluate the progression of glaucoma. So whether the percentage of disc occupied by the optic cup got increased or not. So they will check. This is also a test for glaucoma. Applanation tonometry and cup to disc ratio. And cylindrical correction. Cylindrical correction was putting the glasses. So nothing but they'll use the lens to produce different refractive power. So we will have different powers, +1, +2, +3, or -1, -2. So to correct the nearsightedness and farsightedness, at the same time, astigmatism, which is blurred vision. And femtosecond laser, which is a short pulse laser. So usually to create the corneal flaps in refractive surgery. Refractive surgery means, so to get rid of the glasses. So many people are nowadays, they are going for laser surgery. So that is femtosecond laser. Glare test. What the glare test will see is, they'll put a bright light in front of us. And they will check at what distance we are feeling the glare. So for some people, they can feel the glare when the light is very near to them. Some people, they can feel the glare very far away from them. So that they will check in glare test. And gonioscopy. So they'll check the anterior chamber or angle of the lens. And goniotomy, with using the surgical procedure. So to treat the congenital glaucoma. And it consists of, they will cut the trabecular meshwork usually in goniotomy. And intraocular lens. So the lens that may be surgically implanted to replace the eye's natural lenses. So usually this will be done in cataract surgery. In cataract surgery, they will remove the normal lenses and they will put the artificial lens. And iridectomy. Surgically removing a portion of iris muscle. Keratectomy. Surgically removing the corneal tissue. keratolysis, we also call it as corneal melt. So this is because of severe inflammation of the eyeball. And keratoplasty, surgical repair of the cornea. So keratotomy. Keratotomy means an incision on into the cornea, we call it. Any cut on the cornea, we call it as keratotomy. So when to perform the surgery, they have to cut the cornea, that is keratotomy. And LASIK. LASIK is laser insulu keratomeliitis. So which is the surgery because of the pupil, to correcting the pupil size. So they will put the laser into the eye. So nowadays, they are not using this LASIK. LASIK is before 10 years before they used to use this LASIK. So to change its optical power, to correct the myopia, hyperopia and astigmatism. And lensectomy, surgical removal of the natural lenses. And ocular biometry. So this is to test the ocular structures, like very similar to ultrasound scan. So to see the interior of the eyeball, how the eye is there, everything inside the eye. And ocular surface disease index, ocular surface disease index, which is not a test, it was a questionnaire to test whether the person is having dry eye or not. Dry eye means inflammation of that entire eye. We also call it as corneal melt. So they will ask the persons, they'll have 12 set of questions, like whether they can able to see the objects near or far, whether they can see the light for a long period of time. While seeing the light, so will they have tears or itching, pain, like questionnaires will be there. They have to fill the questionnaires. According to their answers, the physician will suspect whether the person is having dry eye disease or not. So this is all about the eyeball, its anatomy, physiology and pathology, surgical procedures and diagnostic procedures. Okay, any doubts regarding this topic?
Yeah, what is this macular tissue?
So macula means that middle layer, choroid layer, we call it as macula. Macula means color.
Okay. And one more thing, trabecular meshwork.
Trabecular meshwork is present. This is also in the middle layer only.
Okay, thank you.
Any other? Any other?
No.
Okay, right. I'll share you the